Let us talk a little bit about money. Not just about sugar money, because we know there has been a lot of sugar money around the place right now when people are sweeter.
16 million of it.
And there are those who have said that your administration can't come up with a budget, making it appear that somehow you are incompetent. I know that you are a man who went all the way in accounts. So my question to you is, will you have a budget this year? And the other question is about what the IMF has been saying about projected growth for St. Kitts and Nevis. There are those who are saying, well, your administration is new, and so therefore that you cannot take responsibility for the growth.
The budget is an easy exercise, and indeed, I serve as Minister of Finance for at least 2 years. I presented budgets to this country. And so, not only from the vantage point of my own enormous training in accounting and public accounting, for that matter, can we produce it if we want, and there's a need to, but also from the vantage point of the experience. And let the record show that for the first time in the life of the Douglas administration, when a surplus was realized, was under my watch as Minister of Finance. For two consecutive years, $136 million in surplus and about 141. Before that time, the records of the Director of Audit would reflect that from 1995 onward, whilst Dr. Douglas served as Minister of Finance, he ran the country in red. Indeed, it was that red ink that set the stage in 2010, 2011, for St. Kitts and Nevis to go to the IMF begging for help, five times the normal quantum of assistance that the IMF would give to any country. But that being said, a budget has already been passed for 2015. And certainly the government could have come in and said, well, let's do over our budget. But what good would that have done to the country? To take the civil servants, already some of them, in their stage of inaction, depression, some of them, and ask them to begin to redo a budget, which really, in real terms, was not absolutely necessary, because we are a country of laws. The budget is a law. That law had been passed in December of 2014, given the legal requirements for expenditure and collection of revenue in 2015. So there was no imperative, no necessity, an account of law or practice for there to be a new budget. Neither in the context of a just concluded election was it prudent, in my view, to proceed to get those civil servants, like the one who was backdating contracts, like the Erasmuses, to put a budget together again for the new government. Because you were duplicating, and duplicating effort did not make sense in the context of a mere 2 months. In fact, the budget process cycle started on the 1st January, and there's a budget. And that took a lot of hard work on the part of civil servants to get it there. So why come in February you're going to undo what there was no need to do? So this talk about budget is really political hogwash with no merit and no basis. The point is, though, that we will have an opportunity to bring our budget in December of 2015, and we are getting ready to do that. And it will be a budget that will be different in substance, in tone, and in style than that last presented by the rejected regime. We are a group of competent people. We know what to do. And it is because we know what to do and we have the people's trust while we are here. It is because we know what to do that the IMF has predicted that under our watch, the economy will grow. And of course, we take credit for it. Because in fact, if the IMF had predicted that the country was going to fall in, Well, what would they say? They wouldn't take credit that they were the last government. They will say they are the government. Well, the government must take responsibility for the good and the bad that happens under its watch. And the point is that we took over in February, and there were ample time for the economy to go zigzag, as it were. There were ample time for the economy to fall off, but the economy hasn't. And so the IMF has said that we are going forward in a positive way with a 5% growth. And I want to make the point that under our watch, since we have gotten there, more businesses have been recorded than were recorded for the similar interval last year. A fresh year has come. A fresh start has come to a number of people. And people are up doing business, creating jobs, and creating revenues for themselves. So we are pleased by that. And I want quickly, if you will, and it may come in the call, touch in the heartfelt pleasure that I have and our cabinet has in the fact that within a very short period of time, one of the principal commitments made by the Team Unity to pay aggrieved sugar workers the $16 million for which they were shortcharged, that we have been able to do it. And we did it in the context of they saying it couldn't be done. We did it against the fact that they said no more money was there. We found money, and not one cent of it came from the treasury. And we did it with so much style that while they only paid 950 plus former sugar workers, we in 2015 have paid over 2,311. 2,311. So we have more than double up in terms of the beneficiaries. In other words, more former sugar workers now in 2015 receive something than they did in 2005, 2006. And that, for me, is a significant achievement. A substantial portion of those who received had also received in 2005. But the significant number of those who receive now did not receive anything at all, like Joe Hercules, like Alan Rubin out of Sadler's, like Vera Samuel out of Tabernacle, like Kenzie out of Tabernacle, and several other hundreds of people to the length and breadth of the country, unconscionably denied the rights from their labor, have now been put in a better position. And I said this last point in relation to it. If it is $5 more we pay to anybody, it is $5 that you would not have gotten under Douglas administration. You are better because of Team Unity. And several of those who did not believe us are now the people wanting to create mischief about this payment. When they voted against the payment, when they accepted the view that it couldn't be done, when they accepted the view that all the payments had been properly made. So if they were properly made, then there can't be any expectation for further. We said no, and we followed through on that particular matter and bring much joy and sweetness to the country during the week of independence. I want to say thank you to all those people, to John Paul, to the lady 93 years who came to Bath Stair to receive her money, to Samuel Chemical Wilson, who met a president from a big country called Venezuela. And that ordinary man was only able to meet the president of Venezuela because the Harris administration, through their own quiet diplomacy on behalf of the people, brought the president Maduro here to participate in this event, a milestone event in our program of delivery. And so I am grateful and say, to God be the glory for all that we have been able to accomplish. And there are so many more. which we have not touched on, but perhaps during the course of the program, we will revert again to our program of delivery, because I am so proud and pleased of our success to date that there's nothing that anyone can say to dissuade me from the focused approach to governance which we have brought to this country.